Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Paul Baay from Touchstone Exploration. Paul, I believe you've got some news for us about the Coho gas stream coming online. Can you tell us all about it?
Yes, really exciting for us. It came on stream on to full production on Monday. Actually been sort of commissioning it over the last 10 or 15 days since we got the government approval. But this is our first gas discovery in Trinidad that we've been able to bring on stream. And it's, currently producing around 10 million cubic feet a day. It's been a long, long process for us to get from drilling it to on production, but it's now on production and running. And the facility's capable of about 20 million a day, just over 20 million a day, 24 million a day. So we'll just monitor the well here, and then we can figure out whether we want to ramp it up from here or leave it where it's at. But really exciting. The other thing it does is it basically doubled production on Monday for us, which I think is pretty significant. And it adds natural gas to our commodity mix, which, now we're virtually 50-50 in what we're looking at doing. So, it transformed the company on a whole bunch of fronts as of Monday.
Fantastic. Now, you mentioned that it's been a rather a long process. There have been some delays. Can you give us a bit more detail about those?
Yeah, I think there was a lot of learning. This is the first gas that's come on stream in Trinidad in over 20 years. So I think there was, learnings on our side, on the government side, on the National Gas Company, on everybody's side. And one of the challenges here was that there was a lot of parties involved. We're going into a third-party gas plant that's operated by one of the majors. So obviously that presented some challenges just on how they did business and some of the specs that they needed. And then the second thing from our point of view was just getting all the approvals in place and finding all the right operators on the island to put the whole project together. And it just took us a lot longer. And that, I think the thing that I sometimes forget, and the team did a really good job, as most of this was built during COVID, which wasn't the ideal time to be doing this. But all that aside, I think, it took longer than it should have. We know that we'll take full ownership of that. But I think what it's really done is set up a really nice sort of business stream for us as we go forward and bring on the next stage of gas that we've got.
Mm-hmm. And do you think there are some lessons you can learn from this tortuous process?
Yeah, I think there's a couple. The biggest one for us is that we had done this as a turnkey project where we gave it to one contractor to design, build, and put into service the entire project. And what we've done now is we've gone with help both on and off the island, doing the full design work by somebody that's expert at doing design. We then bid out the various phases of the next project that we're going to do. It's all being constructed on the island in various shops, and then going to be assembled on the location versus the way we did it before, which was to, start from ground zero on the facility. So, I think there's lots of things we've learned. And I think the other thing too is on the government side and on the National Gas Company side, we all are now working better. We know who everybody is. We know all the different things that we need to get approvals on to make this thing happen. So yeah, lots of good things learned for sure.
Now you've got some excess capacity at the Coho facility. Can you tell us what you're going to do with it?
Well, as I mentioned, it's the facility is designed for 24 million a day. We're doing about 10, just over 10 million a day. Now there's really two things we can do. We can look at if the well performs as we think it might, that we'll be able to ramp that up in the future. I think what's more likely though is would be probably a second well into kind of a second part of the reservoir there at Coho. Somewhere down the road, probably I would say over the next year, and then we can ramp it up from there in what we see taken up to the full 24 million. So, we want to build a little excess capacity for future drilling, and that's what we've done here.
And can you give us a quick update on the Cascadura project?
Yeah, and that's really the project that's going to benefit by what's gone on at Coho and what we've learned at Coho. So that actually got kicked off pretty well the middle of August when we got the approval from the environment department on that, sort of put all the pieces in place, and then actually got going in September, and in early mid-October, we're out in the field now, basically getting the civil work done, which is, building that lease a little bigger that we need to do. The next thing that will happen is we'll pour the concrete pad. But running in parallel with that, as I mentioned earlier, we're doing all the construction work, like all the big pieces, the compressors, the separators. They're actually all sitting in our yard in Trinidad. And then in various shops around Trinidad, we've got various different pieces of the project getting put together. So that what'll basically happen once that surface lease is done, then everything will come out and be assembled. We're actually heading down to Trinidad with the entire engineering group to do a big kickoff meeting and sort of coordinate all of that. So that's the kind of stuff that we learned about Coho that we're doing very different at Cascadura. Mm-hmm.
And finally, Paul, there have been some fiscal changes down in Trinidad and Tobago. Are they going to affect Touchstone in any way?
The budget that came out in the last little while, number one, it showed the strength of the country. I think they've really got their act together, and things seem to be going in the right direction from the revenue point of view side for the country. The one big change that happened is the rate at which we get charged a surplus on our oil. The price went from $50 to $75, the base price. So that actually, just to give you an idea, at Cascadura, that'll add about $5 million a year to our funds flow at the bottom line, just off out of that one facility. So yeah, it was it's a fairly significant change. Doesn't affect any of our gas pricing or gas royalties, but it does affect a thing called the SPT, the supplemental petroleum tax, which affects us at Cascadura with all the liquids. So step in the right direction, not as far as we would have liked to have seen. We still think there's a lot more room to improve the fiscal regime for the energy sector in Trinidad, but definitely a step in the right direction for us.
Paul Baay from Touchstone Exploration, thanks very much for joining us on Proactive.
Thank you very much for the time.